Hello and welcome again to the Dyverso Snow tutorials for RealFlow 10. In this lesson, we're going to dissolve and blow away some letters made of snow. But please watch the snow parameters tutorial first to get a better understanding of the parameters we'll be using now. Here, we start with the word snow. Open the text tool and enter snow. Choose a nice font, just what you like. Here I've chosen the Ephra typeset. Confirm with OK and disable Create Multibody because we need the individual letters. Plane depends on your current axis setup and here it's going to be XY. To get 3D letters, extrude the text. A value of around 2 is good. But now the letters appear flipped and the reason is that my axis setup is for Cinema 4D. To change that, go to the Preferences panel where you can choose from various presets. To fix it here, rotate the parenting null by 180 degrees around the y-axis. Then move the letters a few units upwards and add a ground object. Also make the ground cube large enough because it has to catch all particles and make it thick enough to prevent the particles from going through the floor. Now we need an animated sphere. The idea is to shift all particles which collide with the sphere to a second domain and let several demons act on them. So we have to adjust simulation range to, let's say, 160 frames and animate the sphere by adding keys to its position values. Now we need 4 Dyverso fill emitters. That's one for each letter. Many ReFlow nodes can be cloned with a Ctrl-D shortcut and on the Mac it's simply Command-D. The letters have to be connected to their appropriate fill emitters. And once done, we can start with the basic settings from the first snow tutorial. Of course, it's possible to use different values and change the material's properties, but the ones shown here are a good start. For snow, I prefer code colors and the domain's color gradient can be changed under the Display tab. And don't forget to adjust Dyverso subsets and iterations under ReFlow simulation options next to the Simulate button. Just enter the following values. If you have a modern graphic card, then you should also enable the GPU mode to accelerate your simulations. To get a better snow object interaction, it is also a good idea to activate the ground cube's continuous collision detection. We unlink the text objects, but as emitter objects, they will be ignored anyway. And then there are not enough particles. A resolution of 100 is good for now. We can also see that we have to work on the letters to get a better particle representation. Cell size is what we need and we decrease its value to 0.025. The sphere should be inactive for now as well. Okay, let's take a look at what we've created so far. The result is not really good and it seems as if our settings are responsible for these changes in velocity. Fortunately, we can fix this easily because the particles here don't have to behave like snow. Only the filtered particles have to have these snow attributes. So we set the friction values to 0.5 to keep the particles together. And the following parameters can be 0, but damping should be high. Damping introduces viscosity and this will calm down the particles. I'd say it's time to check the effect of our changes. Yes, that's very good. The particles don't move and there is no visible change in velocity anymore. This means we are ready to add the second Dyverso domain. We just apply the basic snow settings from the beginning and also change the color gradient. Special case is resolution. To avoid instabilities, both domains should have equal values. And in the next step, a filter daemon is being added. We specify target and source domain and define a condition. Particles colliding with the sphere will now be shifted from domain 1 to domain 2, and the particles of the second domain should be influenced by a gravity daemon. Edit and make it exclusive to the second domain. The ground cube has to interact with domain 2 as well. More ground friction is also a good idea. Set die friction to 0.5. Time for another simulation. Our concept works great, but I don't like how the letters are influenced by the filtered particles, and I think it's better to separate the domains. Now the effect turns out better, but the result is not very impressive. Because the snow is just falling down, we need more chaos and turbulence. As always in such a case, we create a noise field daemon to disturb the particles. Edit, change strength to 6 and increase space scale. Then connect it to the second domain. We're getting there, and the only missing piece is a wind daemon. Wind direction should be in direction of the sphere's motion, so this hollow arrowhead has to point to the right. To blow away the particles, we need a rather high wind strength. Let's start with 8. Of course, the wind daemon has to be exclusive to the second domain as well. And now we get these clumps and pieces we've been looking for. All in all, this is very close to what you've seen in the introduction, and there are only a few more things to change. First of all, we switch to the final resolution. 500 should be enough for both domains. Since the number of particles is one of the most important parameters, we should check immediately what we get. I'd say wind strength could be a little stronger, and the particles on the ground are affected by the wind and noise daemons. This is something I want to change. So we make the wind daemon bounded. With the radius values, we create a wind tunnel, and the tunnel's height will be around 8 meters. Be careful, because the bounding volume must not touch the ground cube. Then we activate the noise fields, fall off and make it visible. Rescale and reposition the daemon, and make sure that it doesn't touch the ground either. Finally, decrease the fall-off zone and simulate. And here is the final version already from a camera's perspective. But of course you can do some fine-tuning of the parameters or create something different like sand, for example. So thanks for watching, and let it snow with RealFlow 10. Goodbye.